Today we shall see the intrinsic properties of the nucleus. The intrinsic property are those properties which are possessed by the nuclei by virtue of its nature. Now this property includes the size of the nucleus, the volume of the nucleus, the density of the nucleus, the charge of the nucleus and the mass of the nucleus. So we'll start with the size of the nucleus. Now the size of the nucleus can be found out by the method of the closest distance of approach. So in this method, there is a alpha particle and there is a nucleus. And the alpha particle is made to collide head on with the nucleus. So what happens is that this alpha particle possesses some kinetic energy, and when it starts its journey, as it is far away from the nucleus, then it has only the kinetic energy and no potential energy. So when it comes closer to the nucleus, due to the repulsive force, due to the this charge of the nucleus, it approaches some distance closer to the nucleus, and after that, due to the this repulsive force, it starts going back. That is, all the kinetic energy is now transformed into potential energy. At this point, where it cannot go any further and starts turning back, this is the distance which is called the distance of the closest approach, and this is denoted by this D. So if E K be the kinetic energy of the alpha particle, now it reaches here, and this is the distance of closest approach. This distance, that is the distance of this alpha particle and this distance of this nucleus, the centers are d apart, and this is the distance of the closest approach. Now here all the kinetic energy is transformed into potential energy. That is, Ek is equal to Ep, and this is equal to 2E into Ze. We have taken a nucleus having atomic number Z. So total charge is Ze. An alpha particle, we know that the total charge is 2E. So this by 4 pi epsilon naught d, or Ek is equal to 2ZE square by 4 pi epsilon naught d, or d is equal to 2ze square by 4 pi epsilon naught Ek. So let this be equation number 1. So from here the distance of closest approach can be found out. So it may happen for some alpha particle having a very high kinetic energy, so that it reaches very close to the nucleus, and instead of going back, it is attracted by the nuclear force. And so it will not turn back, but it will go in the same path. So if that kinetic energy is known, then this D will be known, and that D will be the radius of the nucleus. Then that D can be supposed to be the radius of the nucleus. So in this way, the radius of the nucleus can be found out, and it was found that it is something around 10 to the power minus 15 to 10 to the power minus 14 meter. So this is the method for finding the size of the nucleus by the process of, or the method of, the closest distance, approach of closest distance. Now, also by doing experiments on various nuclei, it was found that the radius R of the nucleus is equal to R naught e to the power 1 by 3, where A is the mass number of the nucleus, and R naught is a constant, which is related to the distance of closest approach. And this is called nucleus radius parameter. And it has value which is between 1.3 to 1.5 into 10 to the power minus 15 meter. Next, we shall see the volume of the nucleus. Volume of the nucleus is given by V equal to 4 by 3 pi R cube, where R is the radius of the nucleus. So this is equal to 4 by 3 pi, in place of R we can write R naught e to the power 1 by 3, and this is equal to 4 by 3 pi R naught cube A, and this is 4 by 3 pi R naught cube is a constant, and we can write it as V naught A. So the volume V is equal to V naught A. So from here we see volume V is proportional to the mass number of the nucleus. So the volume of the nucleus smoothly increases with the mass number of the nucleus. Next, we shall see the density of the nucleus. The density of the nucleus is given by, suppose rho, that is mass of the nucleus, by volume of the nucleus, and this is equal to A into 1 atomic mass unit by 4 by 3 pi r cube, and this is equal to 1 A into 1 amu by 4 by 3 pi r naught a to the power 1 by 3 cube, and this is equal to a into 1 amu by 4 by 3 pi r naught cube a. This a and a cancels out, and if we replace this amu or change it into kg, we'll have 1.660 into 10 to the power minus 27 kg by 4 by 3 pi, and we take the value of r naught as 1.5 into 10 to the power minus 15 meter. So this becomes almost equal to 1.17 into 10 to the power 17 kg per meter cube. So from here we can see that the density of the nucleus is quite high. Now the number of
nucleons
per cubic meter will be given by the number of nucleons per cubic meter is given by the density of the nucleus by the mass of one nucleon. And since we have found out the density, that is equal to 1.17 into 10 to the power 17 kg per meter cube, by we take 1.660 into 10 to the power minus 27 kg. And if you calculate this, we find this equal to almost 10 to the power 44 per meter cube. So you can see how huge this number is. So there are huge number of nucleons per cubic meter. Also, as the density was 1.17 into 10 to the power 17 kg per meter cube, so this number is, can say, is independent of the mass number. This is also a very huge number, so you can see how dense a nucleus is, and this is also independent of the mass number. Next we shall see the variation of the density with respect to the distance from the center of the nucleus. So this is how we find it. Let us see. Variation of the nuclear density with the distance from its center. It is like this. If we plot the density in this axis, that is nuclear density rho, which suppose depends on, which depends on the distance r, and here it is distance from the center this is r. So this is like this. So this is rho naught, or the density at the center of the nucleus, and this is the distance from the center r, and this is nuclear radius r. So you can see that the density remains almost constant up to a certain distance, and once it is closer to the surface, its density decreases, and it decreases gradually. It does not decrease abruptly, it decreases gradually, and it almost becomes zero. That is, you cannot have a well-defined boundary of a nucleus. It is something like this. It is very dense here, and as we move towards the surface, the density gradually decreases. So there is, we cannot say that it has a well-defined boundary, and so this is like this. The variation is like this. It is always a quantum phenomena. Next, we shall see the charge of the nucleus. Now, the nucleus contains protons and the neutrons. The only charged particle are the protons. So if the nucleus contains Z protons, that is, the nucleus has the atomic number Z, therefore the total charge is Ze, where Z is the atomic number and E is the basic unit of the charge. So this is the total charge of the nucleus. Next is mass of the nucleus. So again, the nucleus contains protons and neutrons, and suppose a nucleus contains or has Z atomic number, and number of neutrons be n. Therefore, the mass of the nucleus, if Mp be the mass of proton and Mn be mass of neutron, then the mass should be equal to Z Mp plus N M N, or we can write it as Z Mp plus A minus Z Mn, because n is the number of neutrons, which is given by the mass number minus the atomic number Z. So but when the nuclear masses were measured by
mass spectrometer,
found that this mass or the assumed mass is greater than the mass which were measured by the
mass spectrometer,
that is Z Mp plus A minus Z Mn is greater than the real mass, or Z Mp plus A minus Z Mn minus real mass, if this is equal to delta M, then this delta M is called the mass defect. So we find that the mass of the nucleus is always less than the mass of its constituents, protons and the neutrons together. So these were the intrinsic properties of the nucleus.